Like the great George Strait song, Deep in the Heart of Texas, we take you deep into the heart of the NASCAR garage here on NASCAR.com GarageCam. I'm your host, Matthew Dillner, bringing you all access behind the scenes, live streaming, raw, interactive on NASCAR.com here for a half an hour at Texas Motor Speedway as we get set for the Sprint Cup Series and practice number one here at Texas Motor Speedway. Louis DiDonato, you were first in the chat. Pole position for you, Virginia Wright. Hi, Matt and the crew and the mod. Well, here's our crew today. Matthew Strickard on the tablet right there, and our audio extraordinaire, of course, CJ Letirza, who, by the way, captured some great audio last week. If you saw the video this week, a little behind the scenes of Jeff Gordon's victory celebration. We were going to try to show you Jeff Gordon's car. Well, yeah, he's in tech right over there. But Jeff Gordon's victory celebration on NASCAR.com. And the big screen, big Haas, showing some Jeff Gordon still photos and highlights and lowlights right there. But we had a little behind-the-scenes video of his victory celebration, which was really special. So make sure you go check that out. Great job by CJ, all the boys here. NASCAR.com trying to bring you unique content. That includes this show. And, of course, GarageCam presented by Mobile One. So special thanks for Mobile One, all their involvement with our show. Very proud supporter of NASCAR.com GarageCam. And here's the Ricky Stenhouse Jr. Ford. And, man, they were having a good streak going. But tough luck last week. All weekend long at Martinsville for this team. A lot of frustration at times because they've been going in the right direction. And to have a bad weekend definitely hurt. Tony Stewart in the Bass Pro Shops. The bait shop, baby. The bait shop, number 14. Right alongside the Richard Petty Motorsports, number 9, the Sonic car this weekend. The beautiful colors of Sonic America's drive-in on the Sam Hornish Jr. machine. Here's the number 6 Avocare car of Trevor Bayne. Look at that hamburger. Look at the size of that hamburger, man. That's a substantial hamburger right there, if I've ever seen one. And I know my hamburgers. And you see this right here. You see the putting fuel into this number 6 right now. Got a little spillage right here from filling it with fuel. And you see that's why we put the safety clean mats down to soak up any of that fluid. Environmentally friendly is NASCAR. Of course, when teams change oil, gear fluid, everything here at the track, we bring it to safety clean and it gets recycled. A big part of NASCAR's green initiative. David Reagan's number 55 right here. Oh, you know what? Right alongside is one of the stories of the week, and it's Michael Annett. And Michael, it's been a tough week for your crew, for your team. Tell us, the fans at GarageCam, what happened yesterday and how much of a hole it's put you guys in.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely something we don't deal with week in and week out. This is the first time for me. I think first time for everybody on this team. I was having a really good day yesterday. I was on the elliptical machine. Everything was going right. Just had one of those feelings that, something's going to screw up, this day. And sure enough, crew chief Jay Guy called me and said, "You're not going to believe this. We got a little problem," is the way he put it.
A little problem.
And a little problem. And I think it started out as a little fire and it turned into a blaze. So obviously, I think everybody saw the pictures on Twitter of our hauler on the way out here, pretty much burning to the ground. I haven't heard exactly for sure, but I don't think one thing came out of that hauler that we can use ever again. So it's a shame, but fortunately with HGOT Motorsports, we got a great teammate with Justin Allgaier in the 51. Not only him, but just the entire team. Able to roll out their backup car. Flew a guy out here from BSCI to pour an insert in Justin's seat. Obviously, he and I are quite a bit different in stature. So we're making it work. It's going to be a long weekend. Obviously, running through practice out of the same pit box. We have one set of scales, one hauler. It's going to be a team effort to make this work, but it's pretty cool to see the NASCAR garage. When I got in here this morning, after the guys worked till after midnight last night in here getting everything ready, came in this morning and they said it was pretty much at least one team member, if not many, from every team in this garage came up and asked if they wanted to help. So that was pretty cool to see. And like I said, we've had a lot of adversity this season, and this is, didn't think this was going to come. You know, kind of thought maybe we'd get through these last three and focus on 16. So one more hurdle to make our team stronger, and obviously, you know, this team does pretty good with adversity against us. So I'm looking forward to the weekend.
All right, Michael Annett, we appreciate you joining us on NASCAR.com GarageCam. And of course, if you didn't see the story, the number 46 hauler caught fire this week, yesterday, and definitely a very severe fire. But we like to report that everybody that was involved is okay. That's the main thing this team was talking about. The fact that, you know, race cars can be replaced, and they lost both of the race cars here with this team, but the race cars can be replaced, but the people cannot. So the equipment, of course, is on the back burner. But if you look, this team working really hard. You see the Brandt decals right there, decaled over. You can kind of see them faded underneath here, the Michael Annett machine. And as he talked about, quite a size difference. And of course, Michael Annett's seats are all with Michael Annett's car. So Justin Allgaier's seat had to get an insert poured into it to get Michael Annett comfortable and safe in this number 46 race car. And there is his teammate right alongside the number 51, 8 Scott Motorsports entry. That's the primary car for Justin Allgaier. Hard-working group over here at 8 Scott Motorsports. They definitely have a challenge ahead of them, and they worked all night last night to get this car prepped from the backup and get it prepped for Michael Annett. And you can see the team working really hard right now still in the garage area. News that is still developing here in our garage. Great to have Michael Annett on the show, and they'll get through that adversity. Here's the David Gilliland machine. As you can hear, it's a little loud here. The number 40, you gotta show the paint scheme on this machine. It's great to see some sponsorship on the number 40 of Landon Castle. K&W Fiber Lock on the side of this green machine. O'Reilly Auto Parts, a big supporter here of Texas Motor Speedway, also on the side, as well as a little Shamrock love there. That's pretty cool to see. The Dallas, big things happen here on the hood of the number 34 of Brett Moffitt. And I gotta tell you though, personally, when I see this number 34 right here, what do I think about? Blue number 34, I think about Wendell Scott. It was really nice to bump into Sybil Scott, daughter of Wendell Scott, at Martinsville last week. A great family from the Virginia area. And of course, Wendell Scott, one of the legends of our sport. And that car reminds me of it right there. Alex Bowman, you see these templates right here. Actually, we'll show you some of this. These are some of the front nose templates when they go through this part of the inspection station, right in the middle of the garage area here. And if you look, they're color-coded, and you go, well, what are they color-coded for? Well, simply put, this is the Ford, this is the Toyota nose, and this is the Chevrolet nose. So a little knowledge for you there. So many different templates and inspection stations that these race cars have to pass through to make it to get on the track. Alex Bowman, the number 7 Tommy Baldwin Racing entry. Road Rippers on the side of that TBR Chevrolet. Number 33, not in stall right now, but Matt DiBenedetto's Dustless Blasting number 83 is. See if we can get some people some shout outs. I know Brenda Worley, I think I saw your name pop across there. So many people hopping in our chat room. I know some people who were at Martinsville last week that were big GarageCam fans, like Tigra. That was pretty cool to hear of her there. Still have yet to meet you, but I love meeting all the GarageCam fans. Make sure you use the hashtag GarageCam on Twitter. Love meeting you guys, love interacting on social media and on NASCAR.com. Moen on the side of the Cole Witt Ford, Front Row Motorsports. And hey, check it out, it's Ryan Preece's orange machine. And look, it's Ryan Preece. All right, we said we were gonna have fun on the show.
Huh?
We said we were gonna have fun on the show this week.
Absolutely. Okay,
I know you are so pumped with this opportunity on this number 98, but of course, and look, pretty cool sponsors right there. Some people are missing you though at the North-South Shootout in Concord, huge modified race. But this is such a huge part of your future right here.
Yeah, it's a huge part. I got to thank Big Red and Tyrants Energy for coming on board. Great drink. I had a chance to drink it myself.
Oh, I gotta stop by later and have some.
I got plenty for you, bud. You'll be wired, but you know, sugar free, really good. It's a great drink, and obviously I'm missing everybody out at the North South Shootout. One of my favorite tracks is Concord, but this is a great opportunity. I did a couple laps with Ryan Newman earlier in the pace car. Had a little fun, and I'm definitely looking forward to get on track with this baby.
Okay, you got your first opportunity in the Cup Series at New Hampshire, last week at Martinsville. All places that you've run before in modifieds, this place here is a 1.5 mile, 24 degree banking beast.
Yeah.
How different is it? And I know, I mean, every driver feels like, wow, the first time they get on the track, it's a little uneasy feeling, but this is such a different deal for you, Ryan.
Yeah, it's totally different. It's kind of like Homestead was for me going out in the Xfinity car. You're just kind of blind, but you know, this year I've really been able to lean on some guys. Ryan Newman, huge help to me. Landon Castle, because I drove for Hillman in the East car, so he's been really helpful too. And obviously Alex Bowman with CBR, just really helpful, and it kind of helps move that learning process along. So I'm really, really excited. Like I said, Zion's with Big Red Energy. It's a great drink, and you got to check it out.
All right, Ryan Preece, thanks for joining us on NASCAR.com. GarageCam, you see that rookie stripe on the back there. Of course, the Ryan Preece, Ryan Newman connection is a modified connection because Ryan Newman, of course, running some of those modified shows when we run companion races with the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series. The young Connecticut driver, a very personable driver. Great to see him in this garage getting an opportunity. It's great to see some of these young drivers that are so successful in NASCAR short track ranks and NASCAR home tracks and the NASCAR Touring Series get their shot. Jeb Burton, right in this 23 right here. And hey, speaking of talented young race car drivers, Ryan Blaney, the Snap-on paint scheme this weekend for the Wood Brothers, number 21 Ford. Been fast about every place they've been. There's Skip Flores, Ryan Flores, a crew member on this machine who's missing the North-South Shootout in Concord, a big modified guy. Keith Arnold, please show the number 32, Joey Gase, and welcome their sponsor aboard. Well, we will. The official additive of NASCAR, Zach, on the side of that 32. Good to see young Joey Gase here in the 32 this weekend. As Skippy Flores gets the tire pressure set here on this number 21 right there, the native New Jersey and guy and one heck of a race car driver himself right there. J.J. Alley Overture on the side of this orange and blue number 26, kind of New York Islanders. Oh, it's kind of purple. I was going to say it's blue and orange like my New York Islanders hockey team, but nah, I'm wrong. It's purple. My wife, Erica, thinks I'm colorblind, but this is proof. Hey, check out this paint scheme. I always love showing you new paint schemes here on NASCAR.com GarageCam. And Michael McDowell's TWD paint scheme is kind of a cool one here. Let's see if we can get to show you guys walk inside the garage area here of Michael McDowell and show you this paint scheme. Pretty slick machine for McDowell. Of course, when you see Michael McDowell in Texas Motor Speedway, you think of that big wreck that he had here. But Michael McDowell, this team right here has Texas roots. So a big weekend for the Levine family racing machine. And you see it on their rug right here, the Texas flag. Team that started in Texas. They now have shops in Concord, North Carolina, right alongside the Charlotte Motor Speedway. You know, Ryan Preece is in that number 98, and that means the number 62, the other premium motorsports car right over here, that does not have a garage area. That's Reed Sorensen in the number 62 car now. Texas Motor Speedway, what a cool place right here it is at Texas Motor Speedway. The state of Texas has hosted 38 races in the history of the state. 38 races, 29 of them, of course, here at the Texas Motor Speedway. Where's the other ones? Well, one of them was in Houston at a place called Meyer Speedway. And then the other eight races, Texas World Speedway, now a lost speedway. It's about to get torn down. So if you're in the Texas area, I think it's about a five-hour drive from here. But I wanted to hit it yesterday. But Texas World Speedway being redeveloped, now a lost speedway in a very unfortunate a place that we used to race at. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to talk to you because I'm losing to you in fantasy hockey. Done. That guy is the master. Booty Barker. Halfway. Hey, halfway, says the flag man. We love to show the flag man right there. Halfway, the old school symbol of halfway. Having fun here on NASCAR.com GarageCam. Hope all you are in the chat room, see if we could give you a few shout-outs, a few people that are watching the show here, including Ann McGregor. Good to see you on, and Mary Goff, Neville, Hunter Neville, DRL. Love seeing all these people populating the chat room here. It's an awesome thing on NASCAR.com. And you know what? We're moving along because right next door, the number three, the Austin Dillon machine. Austin Dillon hosting a charity basketball tournament this past week in North Carolina. Make sure, I think the video is on NASCAR.com right now, so make sure you check it out. Real fun time. His brother Ty Dillon was part of the Dirty Air podcast this week. If you haven't watched that too, make sure you check it out. Myself, Chuck Bush, and Jonathan Merriman killing it this week with special guest Ty Dillon, and talking, of course, about some of the stories in Cup racing right now, which would be maybe Joey Logano, Matt Kenseth, Hunter Neville. You want to see the Biff, baby? Oh, there is the Biff. Fire Ant Killer number 16. Oh, what a beautiful piece that this 16 team has brought this weekend. A slick body. Get ready. This is a place that Greg Biffle circles on his calendar that he's had a lot of success at. Roush Racing really trying to step up their program, closing out the year strong to attack 2016. So this is a very important race for this number 16 team. Hey, of course, there's some big news. Let's get to where we can actually hear. But there's some big news also here. You know, we've got silly season when it comes to the drivers, but it's also silly season for the spotter. So the number 16, of course, Joel Edmonds moved on from this team. Jason Reiner has been the spotter. But now this week, Trevor Bayne's spotter, Freddie Kraft, the Long Island racer himself, who's the spotter now. Freddie Kraft moves over to the 16 bunch to spot for the rest of the season. It looks like next year, too. Jason Reiner moves over to the 6, which is a great natural connection because he has a great relationship with Trevor Bayne. And so much stuff going on. The silly season is huge in spotter world right now because Tyler Green, who's usually spotter for Eric Amarola, has moved over to the number 1 car because Lauren Rainier, their spotter, has retired. Congratulations, Lauren Rainier, a great person in this sport. That means, well, who's in the 43? Who's going to spot the 43? We have Stevie Reeves hops over from the number 27 to the 43. The former USAC racer is now with the 43 team. Well, then who's going to spot for Paul Menard? Billy O moves over from, well, his main duties are Ty Dillon, but he moves over to the 27. So, yeah, if you keep track of that, you might have to rewind and watch a replay and write it all down. But a lot of movement right now in the spotter ranks up on that roof. The eyes of the sky, such an important role here in the NASCAR garage. Leah Bartlett, can I please see Casey Kane? Well, hey, you said please. Why not? Let's get some colorful requests also here because there's some colorful race cars, including the number 42 right here. Oh, stripes, pinstripe. It's like a red and white New York Yankees car or something right here. The target machine of Kyle Larson. Still looking for that elusive first NASCAR Sprint Cup Series win. Could it happen here this weekend? It very well could. A place where you really have to hang it out. High speeds here at this 1.5-mile beast of a super speedway here. Well, it's intermediate track, but it races like a super speedway as far as the speeds. This place is bad fast. The number 43 of Eric Amarola. Crew preparing here for the first practice. It's a 50-minute session, kind of a short session for our first practice session. Qualifying later today, later on this afternoon into the evening, right around dusk time for the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series. And Clint Bowyer. Paul Menard strapping into his Chevrolet. Right alongside the Jimmy Johnson machine. Jimmy Johnson, man, oh man, Jimmy Johnson is the man here. Best driver rating of any driver here. 5-time Texas winner. Get this, okay, Matt Strickert, our producer, and I were talking about this yesterday. He has 5 wins at Texas and 5 second place finishes. Okay, that's 5 wins, 5 seconds in 24 starts. 18 of them in the top 10. It's amazing what Jimmy Johnson's record has been at so many tracks, including Texas Motor Speedway. Matt Kenseth, usually in this number 20 ride. Of course, the big story of the week, the suspension handed down by NASCAR to Matt Kenseth, and they appealed that process yesterday. JGR did. and the appeal was upheld. The ruling was upheld. So Matt Kenseth will not be behind the wheel of this number 20 DeWalt Toyota. The young Eric Jones will be behind the wheel of the number 20 car this weekend. Five wins, of course, for Matt Kenseth this season. But Eric Jones comes in with a checkered flag that's been in his hand earlier this year. Also, his first NASCAR Xfinity Series win came here in the spring. So Eric Jones knows how to get around this place. He'll be hopping in a cup car for the second time and hoping to bring that Texas two-step experience here to this number 20 ride. Here's the number one of Jamie McMurray. What a great run for Jamie Mack last week, the Cessna ride, as he straps into his car. And there is Jamie Mack. Second place run for Jamie McMurray as he gives a wave. Focused and ready here is the crew of the Cessna machine. But what a shout. We got to give a shout out. Credit to where credit is due. For a second place run for this team, fighting and scrapping so hard all year long. And guess what? It paid off. We'll hop in here and show you young points leader in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series, Eric Jones, about to hop in the car for the first time here in the JGR number 20 is Jones, the Michigan native. Winner here in the NASCAR Xfinity Series and leading the points in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series. What a turn of events for this young race car driver. A few years ago, running hobby stocks in Michigan and graduating to late models, a family-run team. And, of course, bringing that family-run team to the Snowball Derby in Pensacola, Florida, where he turned the racing world upside down with a win, beating Kyle Busch. Caught the attention of Kyle Busch. Kyle Busch putting him in his equipment over there in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series, and what do you know, it's led to great opportunities for this nice young man here who is now filling in for Matt Kenseth as he serves a two-race suspension after the incident in Martinsville. Rolling on here past Jamie Mack's car, we were hoping to maybe talk to Jamie Mack because he deserves an interview. He was having fun talking about the fact that he's got to be like Ricky Bobby and run around in his underwear to get one. He didn't get a post-race interview last week on NBC, but there was a lot of things going on. But I'll tell you what, Jamie Mack, nobody in this garage ignored the fact that Jamie McMurray and that team has worked so hard and have really gotten there. They're very close to getting a win together, that team, this year. New paint scheme for Dale Earnhardt Jr. right here. Virginia Wright chiming in the chat room, wanting to see the Mooresville, North Carolina driver. Kelly Blue Book, and then the gold leaf letters, numbers on board. Look at that. That looks cool. Old dirt track style. And there is Dale Earnhardt Jr. talking to a shaggy-looking Ryan Newman, letting the hair kind of grow out there, and the beard scruff kind of growing in. Maybe it's getting close to hunting season. It probably is for Ryan Newman, spending a little time in deer stands that he will be doing in the offseason for sure. The number 31 Quicken Loans driver. The number 11 of Denny Hamlin. And right next door, as we enter the realm of the chasers, you see the yellow spoilers, the yellow on the nose of the cars, and the yellow ribbon where the name is above the windshield. And Joey Logano right here. There is Joseph Logano in his car. He knows that he's got to get a win here at Texas or Phoenix next week to move on to the championship points finale at Homestead, Florida. So a lot of these guys need some wins. And Kurt Busch, oh, man, Kurt Busch has a win here at Texas, and he needs to get one pretty big here as well. But Kurt Busch can get around this track. Running really well last week at Martinsville and got caught up in that incident with Matt Kenseth and Brad Keselowski. So putting them behind the eight ball a little bit. But, you know, hey, this is a place that Kurt Busch can get it done. He's done so before, previous winner here at Texas Motor Speedway. And Brad Keselowski, one of the race buddy cars, so make sure you tune in on Sunday for race buddy. You can see Brad Keselowski, the 4 of Kevin Harvick, the 18 of Kyle Busch, the 19 of Carl Edwards, 22 of Joey Logano, and the number 78 of Martin Truex Jr. Brad Keselowski, 0 wins here at Texas, 1 win in this season. So he's run up front here so many times, but hasn't been able to get that elusive win here at Texas Motor Speedway. Carl Edwards, a sports clip ride. Waving to you right there. Hi, Carl. Kevin Harvick. Oh, wait. There's some cars rolling out early. Let's catch up, because how can we not see the number 24 of Jeff Gordon after that amazing win last week? Jeff Gordon pens his way into the finale at Homestead Miami Speedway. Kyle Busch, the number 78 car of Martin Truex Jr., sits third in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series points. Carl Edwards also in it. After what a recovery for Carl Edwards last week after getting caught up in a little incident at Martinsville and coming back for a strong finish. Here's a guy who's had some pressure taken off of him, at least in the media. And Kevin Harvick, as they get ready to hit the track for practice number one here for the Sprint Cup Series. Oh, it's chase time, baby. This is where all the tension is in this part of the season. Texas Motor Speedway here. 29 Sprint Cup Series races here. 144 different drivers have competed here at the Texas Motor Speedway, and only 18 winners. There's been some repeat winners, though, in Cup Series, seven of them. Jimmy Johnson, Carl Edwards, the Biff. Jeff Burton, of course, who won the inaugural race here in 1997. Denny Hamlin, Kenseth, and Tony Stewart. This guy right here, Kevin Harvick, attempts to get a win here at Texas Motor Speedway as well. As happy. I was wondering why. Cheddar here blocking me, throwing the block. That was impressive, Cheddar. That was probably one of the best blocks I've seen all year. Kevin Harvick strapping in to this machine right here. William Briggs. Okay, Matt, let's see Kevin Harvick's colorful Budweiser car. Well, there is the King of Beers Chevrolet, the Stuart Haas entry. Things are firing up here in the NASCAR garage area. Crew chiefs are hopping on top of the haulers. The cars are starting to roll out here under the sunshine, the blue skies of Texas Motor Speedway. Oh, you hear them firing up in the background. Just minutes until practice is underway. Brad Keselowski's Deuce rolling out. 1 minute till practice takes the green flag here at Texas Motor Speedway. NASCAR's most popular driver, Dale Earnhardt Jr., strapping into the Kelley Blue Book, number 88. Make sure you tune into the AAA Texas 500 Sunday, 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on NBC. Oh, yeah, NBC, PRN, and Sirius XM Satellite Radio. Make sure you also tune into NASCAR.com GarageCam, the next GarageCam show coming to you in just a short little bit. 12:30 p.m. Central Time, that's local here. That would be 1:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, the NASCAR Xfinity Series live on NASCAR.com. Oh, it's going to be a fun show. We always have fun in the garage area there with the NASCAR Xfinity Series. And, of course, the story of the weekend has been Matt Kenseth, has been Joey Logano. So what better way to close out the show than the number 22? Six wins on the season for this Ford out of the Penske Stables. The Connecticut driver has some pressure on him right now. But you know what? He said that in the media center that this might be a good thing for this team, that they're not really worried, that this team has been able to perform before with those six wins. They're confident that they could get a win here or at Phoenix. This is a place where Joey Logano has a win before. So he's wore that big old Texas cowboy hat in victory lane. Can he wear it again this weekend? Can he lock himself into that championship four at Homestead, the finale? Oh, so many great moments here at Texas Motor Speedway. Year 2000, Dale Earnhardt Jr. as he rolls out. His rookie win, his first win in the Cup Series. Denny Hamlin right here in the number 11. I'm getting blocked a lot today. Having fun here in the NASCAR garage. So many great moments here. Why? Why are they getting even more great? Because this race has so much drama attached to it now. The chase has so much drama attached to it because, hey, it's put up or shut up time for some of these race car drivers. You gotta win, baby. That's what NASCAR is all about. Joey Logano hopes to do so this weekend. This AAA auto insurance machine in the garage, ready to go out. This is Garage Cam. I'm your host, Matthew Dillner. Make sure you tune in to NASCAR Xfinity Series Garage Cam, 1:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Oh, and enjoy Big Texas. Until next time, we'll see you at the races.